The Dominican Republic's northern coast has a reputation, and not just for its beauty.
One, two, three, four, five.
Here,
six,
it's easy to hire a boat and captain to cross the treacherous Mona Passage to Puerto Rico. This man, who prefers to remain anonymous, has taken several boatloads of illegal migrants across these waters.
The more they drown, the more they keep on attempting to cross, and they're not afraid. A lot of people have died, a lot have made it. We risk ourselves because of our condition.
The dangers of making the crossing are all too real for Lorenza Santiago. She only has this faded picture of her late husband, Pedro. He drowned 2 years ago. His body was never recovered, and now she's struggling to feed her three children.
He told me I'm going to Puerto Rico to go for 2 or 3 years to buy a house for the children to give them a better future. I didn't want him to go. I told him not to go, but he told me he had to.
These boats never made the crossing to Puerto Rico. They were confiscated and now sit here in the local Navy Yard, symbols of desperation. At least 20 people will pack into a boat like this, spending thousands of dollars in the hope of a better life. But for those who manage to make it safely here to Puerto Rico, their journeys have only just begun.
At the San Mateo Church in San Juan, Father Olin Pierre Louis offers new arrivals shelter and advice. He's helped hundreds of Haitians settle in places like Miami and New York, but without money or family contacts, many will remain in limbo.
It's like the lottery, a chance. They look for a better life. And like the lottery, you play to win, but you can also lose. They play with their lives.
But despite the massive risks, people like David Delva say they have nothing to lose.
What we left behind was a dangerous world, and that's why I'm so happy now. We are in a better world. I like that. That's why we struggled to get here from a place that has no joy, and when we were always scared of failure.
These men and women risked all to come here, driven by desperation and filled with hope. And while they may not know what lies ahead, they're taking the gamble that it's better than what they left behind. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, San Juan, Puerto Rico.